Hello, my name is Isabelle Cao. I am a studies engineer at the MAP laboratory. I will present the management of control vocabularies within the IOLI platform with the OpenTESO tool. Next slide, please. First, I will recall our activities within the work package 4. Then I will introduce the IOLI platform and the OpenTESO tool. Next, I will present the implementation of the OpenTESO tool within the IOLI platform. Finally, I will share with you the vocabularies we have collected and integrated. And I will conclude on the pursuits and prospects of this work. Next, please. The main activities of this year focused on the development of the features defined in the deliverable 4.16 specification of the new features of the IOLI platform, which concern the technical robustness of the platform, the collaboration framework, the management of control vocabularies that I will develop today, and the compatibility with the Sidox CRM in collaboration with Forth. Next, please. The IOLI platform is a reality-based 3D annotation software for the collaborative documentation of cultural heritage. It allows the automatic generation of a 3D point cloud from a set of images acquired according to the photogrammetry protocol. The photography are specialized around the 3D model and can be directly enriched with semantic annotations and additional resources related to a cultural heritage object. The annotations are automatically propagated to all images in the dataset, so the digital objects and the annotation are visualized in 3D. Next, please. So there is a lot to say about the platform and how it works, but today we will focus on the control vocabularies aspects. The collaboration framework is central in the IOLI platform, but it means a multiplicity of actors involved in the description of the same object. The controlled vocabularies are developed in the IOLI platform to avoid problems related to lexical disambiguation, such as homography, polysemy, synonymy, and promote consistency of terms. It also addresses the need to share and publish structural vocabularies in the RDF and ESCOS standard. The use of control vocabularies in IOLI will allow to assign types to annotations and help users describe them. So we chose the OpenTESO tool to manage and create thesauri in ESCOS. Next, please. OpenTESO is a thesaurus management software that complies with the ISO standard for thesauri. It has been developed at MOM-CNRS since 2006. It is distributed in open source on GitHub, and it is supported by many partners, including the MASA Consortium and Humanum. Next, please. Now I will present you the main features of the tool. It offers interface elements to create, insert, and manage thesauri. The import and export in RDF formats are supported. It is also possible to import in CSV and the list of terms. OpenTESO has a complete REST type web service that allows the integration or interconnection of other programs. Next, please. The concepts management is quite simple and intuitive. After login, the edit buttons are accessible to work on the concept. The center view allows you to see the details of the concept with all the information about it. You have to select a particular concept to enrich it. For a concept, you can add synonyms, notes, translations, but also create relationships of hierarchy and association. So they are all the main features to enrich a concept. Next slide, please. On the left side of the interface, there is a tree navigation where you can navigate through concepts that are already ordered in hierarchy. You have a complete view of the concepts and the hierarchy. You can scroll down from top terms to concepts for quick and easy navigation. There is an automatic synchronization between the left side and the center view. The overview proposed by OpenTezo is that of collections or groups. So you can see the Tezoverse collections where the list of concepts is sorted into alphabetical order. And there are two ways to search for a term. The first using the quick search, which offers the terms as auto-completion. And the second is to use the index to find terms beginning with a word or letter. Next slide, please. Concepts can also be aligned with other thesauri in a semi-automatic alignment. You have to choose the source. There are several sources already pre-configured, such as Wikidata, GeoNames, or even the Getty AAT. The alignment module returns several proposals. You have to choose the right alignment based on several levels of equivalence, which correspond to the ESCOS match. Once validated, we have an additional enrichment of nodes, translations, images, in addition to the alignment. And the automatic alignment also allows you to retrieve GPS coordinates. Next slide, please. The candidate module is another method to add concepts in a collaborative way. We will be able to discuss the candidate concept together. It can already be enriched by adding a node and even translations to be ready for integration into the Tezoverse. So the candidate can be rejected, but if it is validated, it is automatically added. Next slide, please. In OpenTezo, there are four user roles: super admin, admin, manager, and contributor. The super admin has all the rights. Admin manages everything on a particular project and can create users and thesauri. Manager only manages created thesauri. And contributor participates in submitting candidates, notes, and translations. Moreover, it is possible to create projects and manage thesauri and users in it. Next slide, please. Now I'm going to talk about the implementation of OpenTezo within Ayuli. Our solution to integrate control vocabularies in Ayuli is through the implementation of a Docker container of OpenTezo. This implementation also takes into account interface elements to format, insert, and manage lists of multilingual concepts used for the description of the digital cultural heritage. It also takes into account a world autocompletion feature for navigating through terms. Next slide, please. In the dashboard, when you click on the lexicon button, you have a page to manage the thesaurus in your Ayuli projects. There is an automatic synchronization between the thesauri made public in OpenTezo and the lexicon page in Ayuli to manage the thesauri. So all public thesauri in OpenTezo are visible in Ayuli lexicon page. You have to select the public thesauri that you want to use in your Ayuli projects, then you validate the change. Next slide, please. Once you have validated the thesauris to be used in the Ayuli project, they are available in the workspace where you can annotate the images. In the middle, we have the hybrid 2D 3D viewer that allows to see the object in two dimensions, all the photos of the object, but also the object in three dimensions. On the left side, you can find the hierarchy organized in layer groups, layers, and annotations, but also the images that have, been sent to make the project. A layer defines a description form composed of fields, and an annotation is used to fill in the fields of the layer that contains it. Any annotated region is linked to a flexible data container that the users can customize according to their description needs. It allows to avoid rigid descriptive sheets. So user descriptor fields can be defined as multiple types, such as text, numbers, dates, or hyperlink. Values can be freely entered by the user on the automatically generated forms. And with the integration of control vocabularies, these fields also support the control vocabularies defined in OpenTESO, which allows automatic auto-completion of description fields. The results appear on the right side that allows to display all the properties of the selected annotation. Next slide, please. Here are the references of the vocabularies from the CH domain that we collected and integrated. This collection work required transformation into a thesaurus and integration into OpenTESO. These references are known and used in the project in which we participate, in particular the scientific project for the restoration of the Notre Dame de Paris Cathedral. Next slide, please. To conclude, the first world auto-completion experiment is technically functional. However, the implementation of the new version of OpenTESO will solve the problems identified during the technical proof of concept, in particular concerning auto-completion and the public thesaurus overview. It's still a beta version, so we have to experiment and develop the vocabulary section. And it is a step to develop in the future a search engine in a project that would allow to search for annotations within a project itself. Thank you.